الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، شهادة الحق والتوحيد. وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله، وأحذركم وأحذر نفسي من عصيان الخالق ومخالفة أمره. أما بعد، my respected brothers of Islam, this is the first Jum'ah of Ramadan, and almost 1 week of fasting is over. Alhamdulillah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us those who complete fasting the holy month of Ramadan. What are the sunan of fasting? There are few things from the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam which is very important for the fasting person. And some Muslims may ignore it. And that is strongly recommended by the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first one is as-suhoor. That is the meal or the food that we eat before the dawn or before fajr. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة. متفق عليه، رواه بخاري ومسلم. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة. O you people, make suhoor. Eat your meal before the dawn or before fajr. Indeed, there is barakah in having suhoor. So some Muslims will say to you, you know, it's my habit, I don't wake up for suhoor, I don't eat it. That person is openly disobeying the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam came up with, take it and implement it. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. And anything that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told you not to do it, never do it. So this is the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we truly love him, we have to have suhoor. And if you have suhoor, Allah and his angels will send their blessings upon you. The hadith which is narrated by Imam Ahmed, قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: السحور أكلة السحور فيها بركة، وإن لم يجد إلا جرعة من ماء. The Messenger of Allah said, eating suhoor has barakah in it, even though someone may not have except a sip of water. Even if you drink a sip of water, that will have barakah in it. So it is sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said alayhi salatu wa salam, فإن الله وملائكته يصلون على المتسحرين. Indeed, Allah and his messenger sallallahu and his angels are sending their blessings upon those who have the suhoor. So if you do not have suhoor and you do not wake up for suhoor, that means you are going to miss the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal and his messenger. What a big loss. So we have to wake up for suhoor. And even it's not necessary that you have a big meal. The minimum you can do is sip of water. If you drink some water or have few dates, that is enough. So suhoor is the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعن زيد بن ثابت رضي الله عنه قال تسحرنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم قمنا إلى الصلاة. زيد بن ثابت رضي الله عنه said, we had suhoor with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and then we stood up for Fajr. قال أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قلت كم كان بينهما. I said to Zayd bin Thabit, what was the gap between your suhoor and when you stood up for the Fajr? قال قدر 50 آية متفق عليه. He said, it was like reciting 50 surah. 50 surah from the Quran may take roughly like 10-15 minutes. So we ate our suhoor, and after 15 minutes, we stood up for Fajr. So this is the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the scholar said, what is the wisdom behind having suhoor? And they said, when you have suhoor, it will give you strength. You will be so strong throughout the day because you had some food and you drink some water. So all the day you will be strong and you will not feel the fasting. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for Muslims to have suhoor, and it's the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have to have suhoor and never ignore it. The second sunnah is al-ifdar, breaking your fasting. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about breaking our fasting, and he said, لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطر. رواه أبو داود وقال حديث حسن صحيح. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the people will be in good condition. They will be in good as long as they hasten and having their iftar. So the iftar, by the time the sun sets, we have to quickly eat our iftar. Some people, they just say, still there is some light. No, as long as the sun sets, you have to eat your iftar. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the hadith which is narrated by Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu, wa huwa fi sahih al-Bukhari, قال عليه الصلاة والسلام إذا أقبل الليل من ها هنا وأدبر النهار من ها هنا إذا أدبر الليل من ها هنا وأقبل الليل من ها هنا وغربت الشمس فقد أفطر صائم. So the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم says when the day turns away from that side and the night comes from this side and the sun has set down, indeed the fasting person has broken his fasting. So when you make sure that the sun has just set, so after that you quickly have to break your fasting. This is the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يفطر على رطب فإن لم يكن رطب فتميرات فإن لم يكن تميرات كان يحسو حسوة من ماء. رواه ترمذي وأبو داود وغيرهم. أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه said when the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is going to break his fasting, he will start with رطب, that is the unripe date. If he doesn't have the unripe dates, he will go for تميرات, for dates. If he doesn't have dates, he will take some water. He will drink some water. That is the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So ayyuha al-Muslimun, we have to always follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like Allah azza wa jalla said in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Indeed, you have a good example in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the people, the Muslims, will be in good condition. They will always be successful as long as they hasten the iftar. Never delay it, because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never delays breaking his fasting. So we have to follow him. And as soon as the night comes from that side and the day turns from that away from that side and the sun has set down, the person who was fasting has broken his fasting. So this is the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the third one is al-mubahat. Mubahat are the things that is permissible for the Muslim he can do throughout the day while he is fasting, and his fasting will not be nullified. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Move forward, Jazakumullahu khair, and so our brothers will come inside. Jazakumullahu khair. A lot of space in front of you. Everyone, inshallah, move forward, and then they will come. Jazakumullahu khair, mubarakallahu fikum. The other one that is strongly recommended is you can brush your teeth throughout the day while you are fasting. There are some people who make the religion so complicated, and they say to you, brushing your teeth during the day while you are fasting is dislike it. No, there is no hadith that says you cannot brush your teeth while you are fasting. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهذا الحديث متفق عليه قال عليه الصلاة والسلام لولا أن أشق على أمتي لأمرتهم بالسواك عند كل صلاة وفي رواية عند كل وضوء. So the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if I was not making complicated for my ummah, I would have commanded them to brush their teeth at every salah. In another narration, at every wudu. So it's strongly recommended that you brush your teeth throughout the day while you are fasting. And when the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَلَخَلُوف فَمُصَائِمْ أَضْيَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. The fast, the breath of the fasting person is, the fasting person is more like it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means this breath is coming from your stomach and it's not the one that's coming from your mouth. So you can brush your teeth throughout the day, and if you see some blood coming from your, that doesn't nullify your fasting. The other one which is permissible is you can take a shower throughout the day. If you want to cool yourself down, you can take shower as long as the water doesn't go into your mouth. You can take shower and you can enjoy, you can cool yourself throughout the day, because there's no hadith which says you cannot take shower. You can take shower, and alhamdulillah, Islam is so simple and very simple religion. The other one is some of our sisters are asking, we cook food, so we don't know whether it has salt or it, so can we test it? Yes, you can test it. Even some of us men, we cook food in this country. So if you want to test it, you can test it, the food, but you should not swallow it. You test it with your tongue and then you spit it out. So it's permissible to test it. What about putting tahal al-ayn? Some are asking, can we put this that the usually women use it? They can use that one as well throughout the day of Ramadan, and it doesn't nullify their fasting because it's not something that will go into the stomach and nourish it. What about some Muslims also are asking if a dust, I'm working in a dusty place and the dust goes into my nose, my mouth, does it nullify? No, it doesn't, because it cannot replace or substitute the food. Anything that doesn't replace the food does not nullify your fasting. This is the basic understanding of what can nullify your fasting and what cannot. So what about putting perfume on your body? That doesn't, nothing to do with fasting. So you can use bukhur, you can use perfumes, you can put it on your body and that doesn't nullify your fasting. What about donating blood? If you donate blood, that doesn't nullify your fasting because it's not something that will come back into your body, but you cannot receive blood while you are fasting. You cannot take it. Or you cannot take something that can feed your body, can nourish your body. You cannot take that one because that can act like food and can give you strength. That one must be avoided. So these are some of the things that are permissible while we are fasting, and alhamdulillah. Allah sallu wa sallimu ala man umirtum bis salati wa salamu alayhi. Inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Wardallahuma an khulafai rashidin abi bakrin wa umara wa uthmana wa ali. Wa an sairi sahabati wa anna bifadika wujudika wa ihsanaki ya rahman rahimin. Allahumma izzal islam wal muslimin. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وصلاتنا وقراءتنا واذكارنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وقيامنا وقراءتنا للقران يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك الجنه وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل. واقم الصلاه.